Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. This is lecture number 9.8. We are going to design 12-speed gearbox using the PSG design data book. In the earlier lectures, we designed the 6-speed gearbox and the 9-speed gearbox. So in this example, we will solve 12-speed gearbox. Example number 6. A gearbox is to be designed to provide 12 output speeds ranging from 160 to 2000 RPM. The input speed of a motor is 1600 RPM. Choosing a standard speed ratio, construct the speed diagram and the kinematic arrangement. This question was appearing in November 2013, May 2016. Write down the given data. Z, number of steps equal to 12, minimum speed 160 RPM, maximum speed 2000 RPM and the motor speed is 1600 RPM. We calculate the progression ratio, phi equal to n maximum by n minimum to the power 1 by Z minus 1, which is 2000 divided by 160 to the power 1 by 12 minus 1 equal to 1.258. And the standard progression ratio from R40 series, we take 1.25 from R40 by 5. This is R40 series, fifth value in the series. And the series is shown here. So starting from 1. So the progression is 1, 1.06, 1.12, 1.18 and 1.25. This is fifth value. So the R40 series is available in the page number 7.20 in the PSG design data book. And next we have to take the 12 different speeds starting from 160 RPM. The 160 RPM I have shown with a star, yellow color star. So starting from here, every fifth speed we have to take. So 160, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 200, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 250, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 315, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 400, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 500, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 630, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 800, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1000, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1250, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1600, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2000. So these are all the 12 different speeds. And the number of stages here, it is 3. And the structural formula is 2 by 3 by 3. And these are all the 12 speeds. N1 to N12. 160, 200, 250, 315, 400, 500, 630, 800, 1000, 1250, 1600 and 2000. The next we have to draw the structural diagram. For the structural diagram, we have to follow the steps. First, we have to draw vertical lines, U plus 1 vertical lines. That is 4 vertical lines for the 3-stage diagram. U is the number of stages at a convenient distance. We draw 4 vertical lines at a convenient distance and draw an array of horizontal lines intersecting the vertical lines at a distance of log phi. That is log of 1.25 from each other. The number of horizontal lines that is equal to 12. So for 12 speed gearbox, number of horizontal lines is equal to number of steps in the gearbox. And the structural diagram, it gives the number of stages in the gearbox and number of gears in each shaft of the gearbox. So normally in every shaft, there should be minimum, maximum of 3 gears. In some cases, it may exceed to 4 maximum. And this is the structural diagram. So there are 4 vertical lines and 12 horizontal lines. So 3 stages. So first stage, driver shaft to the shaft 2, second stage, shaft 2 to shaft 3, and third stage, shaft 3 to driven shaft. And 12 different speeds starting from 160 to 2000. All the values are given here. And this is the structural diagram. Use pencil and scale to draw the diagram. And use HB pencil. Do not use any pen or sketch pen for drawing the diagram. Then we have to draw the speed chart or the ray diagram. So draw vertical lines, one greater than the structural diagram. So because motor speed is also should be shown in the speed chart, so you have to draw one more vertical line. Draw horizontal lines intersecting the vertical lines at the convenient distance. Then from R40 series, take the minimum speed N1 closest to the value and the you take all the 12 speeds from the R40 series that we have taken the 12 different speeds. And the N60, NM, motor speed 1600 rpm is less than the 2000 rpm, n toll 2000 rpm. So the number of horizontal lines equal to toll. So the motor speed can be accommodated within the toll speed, within the speed chart. The speed chart gives information about the transmission ratio of all transmission and speed value of the gearbox, each gearbox shaft. There are three types of lines connecting the adjacent gearbox shaft using the gears. If the line is horizontal, I equal to 1, that means there is no change in the speed. When the line is inclined upward, I is greater than 1, the speed increases. When the line is inclined downward, I is less than 1, the speed is decreases. So these are all the different three different types of lines in this speed diagram. And there are limitations for the speed transmission ratio. The maximum transmission, when the speed increases, the maximum value limited to 2. When the speed decreases, the minimum value limited to 0.25. The minimum speed reduction is limited to 4, that means 0.25, to keep the radial dimension of the gearbox within the limit. When the speed ratio is less than 0.25, the size of the gear, the center distance will increase. So overall dimension, radial dimension of the gearbox will increase. At the same time, when the speed increases more than 2, the pitch line velocity will increase, and that will increase. When the pitch line velocity is increasing, there will be more stress on the gear tooth surface. To avoid this, we have the limitations. Then this is the speed diagram or the ray diagram with the transmission ratio. All the transmission ratio are calculated. Now we have 5 vertical lines. So 3 stages. So first stage, second stage, third stage, and the motor speed is included. And motor speed is 1600 rpm. So here it is 1600 rpm. From 1600 rpm to the 630 rpm, the input shaft speed of the gearbox, it is reduced outside the gearbox. It may be by gear drive or chain drive or belt drive, depending on the speed ratio and the type of application. And within the gearbox, so this is first stage, it has got 2 output speed. For every speed, there will be 2 output speed. In the second stage also, for every input speed, there will be 2 output speed. At the end of the second stage, you will have 4 output speed. And for every output speed in the second stage, end of the second stage, there will be 3 output speed. In total, there will be 12 output speed on the gear, on the driven shaft of the gearbox. Now the actual speed ratio are calculated. 1.25, 1 by 1.28, that is decreasing. 1.25 increasing, 1 by 1.27 decreasing. So here 1.6 increasing, 1.59 increasing, 1 by 2.52 decreasing. So like that, we have to calculate the speed ratio of all transmission, and we have to write the speed ratio on the transmission lines. Then the values are to be standardized. So the standard values are taken from PSG design data book, page number 8.6 to 8.12. So you have to refer to the table and take the standard transmission ratio. The standard transmission, so this is outside the gearbox, we need not bother about this. So the standard transmission ratio is 1.58, 2.5 and 1.26. So all these values are corrected, and according to the corrected transmission ratio or the standard transmission ratio, the speed is changing. Now the speed, N1 becomes 158.7, N2 becomes 200, N3 it is changed to 252, N4 is changed to 316, N5 is changed to 398.2, N6 is changed to 501.7, N7 is changed to 637, N8 is changed to 790, N9 is changed to 995.4, N10 is changed to 1248.2, and N11 is changed to 1572.7, and N12 instead of 2000 it will be 9981.6. So there is slight change in the speed on either side. Either this may be, the change may be positive or negative, that deviation that we have to calculate. So the deviation is calculated in this table. The original speed from the R40 series is written here, and the corrected speed for the standard speed ratio we have calculated. So the change in percentage of change in the speed. So the percentage of change in the speed is corrected speed minus original speed divided by original speed into 100. So corrected speed minus original speed divided by original speed into 100, then we have to calculate. So this is well within the 2%. So this is good kind of approximation or standardization for the gearbox design. Then we have to take the number of teeth. So there are 4 transmission ratio in the 3 stages of the gearbox. So, first stage, so driver shaft to the shaft 2, 2.5 and 1.58. Second stage, shaft 2 to shaft 3, again 1.58 and 1.26. And the third stage, shaft 3 to driven shaft, 1.26 and 1. So, for the transmission ratio, we have to take number of teeth, the combination. The condition is, the horizontal total should be equal. So, 19 plus 30 equal to 49, 14 plus 35 equal to 49, 16 plus 25 equal to 41, 18 plus 23 equal to 41, 15 plus 19 equal to 34, 17 plus 17 equal to 34. This is the condition to be maintained to have equal radial distance for the transmission, two types of transmission between the two shafts. And based on the number of teeth taken from the standard table from the PhD designator book, page number 8.6 to 8.12, then we have to draw the kinematic arrangement. So, the kinematic arrangement for a 6-speed, 9-speed and 12-speed, you just remember the diagram. Diagram you have to remember and number of teeth you have to take depending on the transmission ratio. The diagram you have to remember, there is no other go. So, this you can practice, you can draw using the pencil, then you can understand. So, rough draw the diagram, always draw the diagram and try to remember the transmission, how to draw the transmission. And the condition here, for the first stage, Z1 plus Z2 equal to Z3 plus Z4 equal to 49. So, Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4. For the second stage, Z5 plus Z6, Z7 plus Z8 equal to 41. And for the third stage, Z9 plus Z10 equal to Z11 plus Z12 equal to Z13 plus Z14 equal to 34. And the all the transmission will take the standard transmission ratio. So, engaging this, the speed is reduced by the ratio 2.5. So, 19, 33, 30, the speed is reducing. And again, there is a red color pair, the speed is increasing by 1.58. And in the second stage, engaging the brown color pair, the speed is decreasing by 1.26. And engaging the blue color pair, the speed is increasing by 1.58. In the third stage, engaging the first pair, the speed is constant, 1. And engaging the second pair, the speed is decreasing by 1.26. And engaging the third pair, the speed is increasing by 1.26. So, this is the kinematic arrangement for the 12-speed gearbox. We stop here. And these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. And I upload the video lectures of all the subject in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel. You can use the videos for your revision and learning the subject in a better way. And to pass in the or score higher mark in the university examination. So, thank you for watching. Post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through WhatsApp number or the mail ID for any clarification on the subject. In the next lecture, we will discuss the design of 18-speed gearbox using the PhD Design Data book. Until then, bye-bye.